Says 13 years ago. So this issue came out in 2014, and the original Spider-Man originally started in the 60s, and that's obviously more than 14 years. But I guess it means 14 years have went by in the Spider-Man storyline. this place after robbing these priceless Fabergé eggs. So that her name is Pandamania, I believe. That's Rhino. No, not Rhino. That's Hippo. I believe her name's like White Rabbit or something like that. And she comes up blasting with her umbrella gun. Pew, pew. Pew, 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 pew. And you can see people are freaking out. And this guy has this little cute baby. And he's like, what the heck is going on? And he's kind of getting pushed around by the panicking crowd. And he's like, hey, I got a baby here. Watch out. And he starts going down. He's falling. He's gonna squish the baby. But then, flip, 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 flip. The way I like to make the web sound is, that's the way I remember it from the Spider-Man TV show in the 90s. Says, gotcha. No squished babies, not on my first day back. Yeah, so it's obviously Spider-Man. So she doesn't like that at all. She's like, eat this. Pew. And then you see Spider-Man's hand, bare hand, with this web shooter. Back and drops the eggs. And Spider-Man says, that's what you get for putting all your Fabergé eggs in one basket. So it's good to know that Peter's sense of humor is back. That's one thing Spider-Man is known for. Our Peter Parker is constantly cracking little jokes like that, even when he's fighting his villains. So you can see Peter webs up the eggs. And he says, someone please check on those in an hour, or that's going to be the world's most expensive omelet. So as you know, or maybe you don't, Peter's web, or Spider-Man's webs, dissolve after an hour. So obviously, the eggs will fall. So, Hippo, he's not too happy about any of this. So he picks up a car, and easily tosses it towards Spider-Man, which you can see him dodging it easily. All you see is a blur, and he says, too late, we're already in the future, see, flying cars. Yeah, he's definitely back with his dad style humor. So the crowd is like, oh, look at this, and she's like, it looks like we got our old Spidey back, and he's, whoa. Spidey says, sorry, this isn't as bad as it looks. So what's he talking about? And where are his gloves? Oh my goodness. Now we see what the problem is. And for some reason, he doesn't have his anything on except for mask, his web shooters, and some impromptu undergarments that he made with his webs, it appears. And he says, okay, this is exactly as bad as it looks. And everyone's kind of freaked out. She's like, ew. Like, whoa, click, 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 click. this was going on, the goblin was attacking Parker Industries, and I guess the city, and the Avengers were helping stop these forces. So you see, Iron Man, Captain America, and I believe that Spider-Woman, but also there's the cyberneticist. That was Dr. Octopus's area of expertise. And he's like, he goes to his, I guess, employees, and he's like, hey, print me out the specs for this. I'll read it tonight. And he's like, hey, man, I'm a genius. I can figure this out. And his workers are like, oh my goodness, he's talking to us. What do we do? So I guess Dr. Octopus wasn't too nice to them. So there's another matter of business that he has to take care of, which is destroying all the spider tech, Spider-Man tech. So you see in this room, all the different costumes, I guess, that Dr. Octopus was using. This, and I swear I'm never going to take it for granted again. swinging through the city. And he's like, yep, it's me, your friendly neighborhood creep. Get lost, you freaking jackbooted thug. So, okay, for some reason, the people don't like Spider-Man. Maybe Dr. Octopus ruined his reputation a little. But Peter's like, whatever, I'm back, that's all that matters. And here's an alarm clang-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a-ling-a my chance for some action. So now we cut back to that scene in the beginning of the issue with this group of villains who just stole the Fabergé eggs. So like I said, Pandamania, Eppo, I believe White Rabbit, this girl that they didn't show before. White Rabbit calls her Gypsy Moth. But just like, no, it's Skin now. Skin. S-K-E-I-N. And she's like, no, you have to have an animal name. We have a motif going on here. Spider-Man is like, I hear that motif, more problems, am I right? So again, with the humor. So, Skin, or if you say that, it's like, yo, don't worry, I'll take care of this punk. So she's gonna unleash her deadly superpowers on him, which is, well, the powers of a mop, I guess. Destroy fabrics. So you see his costume shredding. And Peter's like, okay, this isn't good. I can't let her shred my mask, or else people are gonna know who I am. So he clocks her one. Clock. And then he realized his identity, but she exposed something else, so he quickly makes an undergarment for himself, but it's too late because a lot of people snapped pics already. Click, 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 click. And here we are at Avengers Tower, and Captain America and Spider-Woman, I believe, watching this. And Spider-Woman says, okay, Cap, I'm convinced that's Parker, and he's completely back to normal. And Cap says, how can you tell, Jess? Because that could only happen to him. And Cap's like, I might need a little more proof. And Spider-Man says, I'm serious, no social media. And family don't need to see this, especially, oh god, the Human Torch. So there he is, the Human Torch, Johnny Storm, and he's just dying of laughter because he kind of has like a rivalry with Spider-Man. So it says Johnny Storm's favorite bar. And you can see Mary Jane sitting on this bench watching this. She's like, idiot, and just closes the laptop. And we're back full circle at 49th Street and 6th Avenue. So Peter's already taken care of Spidey costume. And he's this surprised to find Anna sitting there. And she's like, "We have to talk." And remember, he doesn't know that they're dating. You can see him thinking, "Are we living together?" And or maybe he does know that they're dating, but didn't know if they're living together or not. So she wants to know something. She says, "Why haven't you ever told me that you were Spider-Man?" And she has the video loaded up on her laptop. And he is Electro's attack, his first attack on the prison. And I guess it stopped the lights and also the power dampers. It stopped the electricity. And this prisoner's like, so you're the cat girl thing, right? What kind of power? You could always land on your feet or something. I'm shaking. She says, there's more to it. My real power is that I'm
Eventually happened, and he changed into like a more like a spider creature.
out is Houston, Texas. So now he's in Houston, Texas, trying to track him down. And Peter is asking this hotel employee about him. I guess she knows something. So there, you can see that's Peter Parker.
Stuff and text messages, so and you see like some of the